This is the story of Peter and the Wolf. And because it's a musical story, each character is represented by a different instrument of the orchestra. The bird by a flute. The duck by an oboe. The cat by a clarinet in a low register. The grandfather by a bassoon. The wolf by three horns. Peter by the strings of the orchestra. Rifle shots of the hunters by the kettle drum and the big bass drum. And now, here is the story. Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. Of a big tree sat Peter's friend, a little bird. Good morning, Peter, chirped the bird gaily. All is quiet. Just then, a duck came waddling along. She was delighted that Peter had left the gate open and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. Seeing the duck, the little bird flew down upon the grass, settled next to her, and shrugged his shoulders. "Ha-ha," he said, "what kind of bird are you if you can't fly?" "Ho-ho," said the duck, "what kind of bird are you if you can't swim?" And he dived into the pond. Argued and argued, the ducks swimming in the pond, the little bird hopping along the shore. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. He noticed a cat crawling through the grass. Cat thought, "The bird is busy arguing. I'll just grab him." Stealthily, she crept towards him on her velvet paws. "Look out!" shouted Peter, and the bird flew up into the tree. While the duck quacked angrily at the cat from the middle of the pond. The cat walked round the tree and thought, "Is it worth climbing up so high? By the time I get there, the bird will have flown away." Grandfather came out. He was angry because Peter had gone into the meadow. "The meadow is a dangerous place. What would you do if a wolf should come out of the forest?" Attention to his grandfather's words. Boys like him aren't afraid of wolves. Grandfather took Peter by the hand, locked the gate, and led him home. Peter gone, and out gate of the forest came a big grey wolf. In a flash, the cat climbed up the tree. The duck started quacking and in her excitement jumped out of the pond. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer, 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 catching up with her. And then he got her and with one gulp swallowed her. Well now, this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. The little bird on another. Not too close to the cat. The wolf walked round and round the tree, looking at them with greedy eyes. Meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate watching all that was going on. Then he ran home for a strong rope, came back and climbed up a high stone wall. One of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was walking stretched out over the wall. Peter grabbed hold of the branch, and climbed up into the tree. Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and circle round the wolf's head. Only take care that he doesn't catch you." The bird flew just above the wolf's head while he furiously snapped at him from this side and that. How the bird worried the wolf, how the wolf wanted to catch the bird. But the bird was very clever, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso, and carefully letting it down, he caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began jumping wildly, trying to get loose. Peter tied the other end of the rope to the tree. And the more the wolf jumped, the tighter he was caught. Just then, some hunters came out of the woods. They were following the wolf's trail and shooting as they went. Thank you. tree called, "Don't shoot. We've already caught the wolf, and now we're going to take him to the zoo." Imagine the triumphant procession. Peter at the head. After Peter, the hunters leading the wolf. Winding up the procession, Grandfather and the cat. Grandfather was still unhappy. "Well," he said, "and what if Peter hadn't caught the wolf? What then?" Above them flew the little bird. "Look at Peter, look at me," he chirped merrily. "My, what brave fellows we are. We caught a wolf." And they say, if you listened very carefully, you could still hear the duck quacking away inside the wolf, because in his hurry, he had swallowed her alive.